What is the pathway to having it both ways, where you're optimizing around both of those things? And then also, candidly, where do you think there are still real trade-offs for people?
Go back to the 70s with the oil embargo and everybody trying to economize and be as efficient as possible. Back then, that whole movement led to everybody tightening up the building envelopes and minimizing ventilation. But what came out of that? Sick building syndrome. Now with COVID, right, we've seen this heightened awareness and concern about the air quality in buildings. We're starting to think more and more about a framework where it starts with defining your indoor air quality targets. What do we want to achieve? You can think of it in terms of risk with COVID, like number of effective air or equivalent air changes, or you can think of it in terms of CO2 or some other metrics you might want to have. Then it's about let's deploy as much air cleaning and filtration as we can to control as much of that as we possibly can efficiently with those technologies. Then let's use performance-based ventilation design standards to figure out, okay, how much outside air do we need to add on top of the air cleaning and the filtration to achieve those targets? But the last piece then is the monitoring. It's bringing in your technology, you're bringing in, IAQ monitoring to say, okay, are we maintaining those levels? The cycling can give people the comfort that we're able to achieve, healthy, sustainable indoor air quality